on the offensive line. Talk about a football team and the character of a football team and where everything starts. I think it certainly does start up front, as we said already, but that offensive line group, we're going to lean heavily on them and their experience. Those two tackles that I mentioned, we get a player back, Fraser Daniel, who was injured last year right before our scrimmage and missed the entire season. And at that point in time, we felt like he was our best offensive line, so we could get a very valuable player back who started every game in 2017. So just really excited about that group and building around them. We don't have a ton of skill back, but we have three big names and three guys that have played a lot of games for us. Notably, quarterback D'Angelo Fulford has started 29 games for us, I believe. Has a lot of experience, and is an excellent player. We're expecting him to have a very good season. And running back Josh Petroselli has played a great deal for us the past 2 years and returns at running back, and we anticipate him getting a lot of carries. And then at wide receiver, Justin Hill has had a tremendous career already for us, and we're hoping to build on that in his last year. Defensively, we're strong up front, we're strong in the box, so to speak. We return three defensive linemen, Andrew and Adam Pastor, and then Ethan McComb. Also, as a returning starter in that group, and then two inside linebackers in Trey Williams and Mitchell Era. The perimeter of the defense will be our most inexperienced position group on the team. We lost some great players there. Lou Berry was the Division III Defensive Player of the Year last year, and I think just was a tremendous player, along with Gabe Brown, corner, two great safeties, and Austin Blake and Trevor Cox. So this group, we'll have patience with, as they grow and they gain that experience. But it's a young group, but it's a group that I think has some talent, and we're excited to get on the field and work